This video will demonstrate microsurgical clipping of middle cerebral artery and internal carotid artery terminus aneurysms. The patient was in his late 60s. He presented with asymptomatic carotid stenosis and cerebral imaging that showed this incidental left middle cerebral artery bifurcation aneurysm. His past medical history was notable for hyperlipidemia, hypertension, and smoking. He had no positive family history of aneurysms. These aneurysms were identified. On the left, you see a very small middle cerebral artery bifurcation aneurysm pointing laterally. On the right, you see a sagittal view of the carotid terminus with an aneurysm projecting superiorly. These illustrations show the patient position, skin incision, and craniotomy used. The surgical strategy consisted of a right mini-terionyl craniotomy, wide Sylvian split, identification of the middle cerebral artery segments, clipping of the deeper internal carotid artery bifurcation aneurysm, and then clipping of the more superficial middle cerebral artery aneurysm. Here is the exposure through a mini-terionyl craniotomy. The temporal lobe is to your left, and the frontal lobe is to your right, with the Sylvian fissure right in between. The Sylvian fissure was widely split, preserving these little veins crossing the fissure. By following the M3 and M2 vessels downward, the arteries naturally show me the way into these arachnoidal planes. You can see the use of sharp dissection here to separate the frontal and temporal lobes. Here, the temporal trunk is followed down to the aneurysm. Some additional splitting of the more proximal Sylvian fissure is performed next to get all the way down to the carotid cistern and the carotid terminus. This portion of the fissure split can be difficult as the pia from one lobe is opposed to the pia on the opposite lobe. Here, with some dynamic retraction on the frontal lobe, the arachnoid over the optic nerve is incised. Here, the terminus aneurysm comes into view, and you can see how the recurrent artery of Hubner adheres to its backside. Notice how I'm using dynamic retraction, again with my sucker in the right hand, to elevate the frontal lobe and free these arachnoidal adhesions between the aneurysm dome and the frontal lobe. This gives me a beautiful view of the recurrent artery of Hubner as it drapes over the medial fundus of the aneurysm. The recurrent artery is adherent in one additional point right there, but I don't need to overly dissect this aneurysm. I can simply view that cleavage plane, free it up between Hubner and the A1, and I can easily slide my clip blade in that space that I've created and close the neck. Notice how the blades parallel the A1-M1 plane. Inspection now shows that the recurrent artery is well cared for in the back. Here's some dissection in the carotid cistern just to make sure there aren't any other aneurysms on the communicating segment of the carotid artery. The attention now shifts to the middle cerebral artery bifurcation aneurysm, which you see here between the temporal trunk to your left and the frontal trunk to your right. Its broad base requires the use of intersecting clips, this first clip going across the frontal side of the neck. And now as I lift the clip, I can get behind it and apply this upcurved clip to the deeper portion. As I lift the stack further, there's one small remnant of neck right here, and this third mini curved clip goes on that remnant. These three clips nicely reconstruct the bifurcation, which you can see on IC green video angiography, showing preservation of the parent vessels. There's no further filling of the aneurysm as well. Here is our overview showing how the Sylvian fissure and around the corner, the carotid terminus, all come into view through this mini terionyl exposure. The patient tolerated the procedure well. He was neurologically intact and was discharged home after a short stay with us. The postoperative imaging showed preservation of flow in all parent and branch vessels and elimination of both aneurysms. In conclusion, meticulous Sylvian fissure split accesses multiple aneurysms in one surgical stage. Clipping should proceed from deep to superficial to avoid clips obstructing the field or limiting maneuverability. The recurrent artery of Huebner often adheres to the backside of internal carotid artery bifurcation aneurysms. Even small MCA aneurysms may require the multiple intersecting clip construct shown here. Dynamic retraction with the sucker avoids the use of fixed retractors. Thank you.